Hey, I'm Anush Elangovan. I'm the VP of Software Engineering at AMD. I'm here with Emad Barsoum, who leads our AI Models group. Hey, Emad, welcome to Advancing AI.
Thanks, Anush.
Cool. What are the key takeaways from Advancing AI?
The one most important takeaway is developer, and moving fast. So it be enable
every... Wait. You said developer?
Yeah,
okay,
exactly. The things that have you have been preaching always, yeah. It be enable developer to, especially the client, the AMD cloud, and be able to have each developer access in a second to AMD GPU to be able to innovate and run. That will help democratize AI and help more and more people have access to AMD hardware and to build innovation solution on the top of AMD hardware.
Yeah, I think AMD, the developer cloud, I truly believe is going to get a lot of folks easy access.
Exactly.
You just have a GitHub ID, you sign in and you get the access to it. Tell me some more about like the models that you've built, your team has built, the Instella range of models. I think you made a new release today or yesterday. Talk about that.
Yeah, so we have we have a team focused on creating model, everything of course built on AMD cluster. We explore different architecture. We build Instella family of model. Yesterday we released Instella Long, which is long sequence length, 128 sequence length. One thing that we do, we release everything, not just the weight. So we release the source code, the training script, the data set, which very few doing that. And we make sure we're training end-to-end on AMD cluster, and we are the models that we release are competitive in various benchmark with similar size model. So everything released with the code, with the checkpoint, with the data set, so anyone can reproduce and get exactly the same result on AMD hardware.
So it's a permissively licensed, fully open source AI model for LLMs and for
LLM, for visual, for vision language model, for text to video, and also we have some innovation in ML optimization, like speculative decoding. We release PARD, we release multi-modal speculative decoding, and we'll continue have a very strong pipeline. We'll continue release in the open, and I would love to see people try it, give us feedback, and see what they build on the top of it.
That's great to hear that AMD has progressively moved from silicon, the enablement software like ROCm, you know, cluster enterprise AI capabilities that Vamsi announced at the keynote, and now models, right? And I don't think, you know, people realize that AMD is actually developing end-to-end models, which are open source and are publicly available, and it's permissively licensed.
Exactly, it's very permissive license. You can use it whatever you want for research, for commercial, it's up to you. It's very permissive license.
That is very good to hear. Are there any other trends that you've noticed in advancing AI? What any other takeaways?
So the other takeaway is the speed. Look at the tremendous progress that the team did for ROCm 7. We are moving very fast, AI is moving very fast. It pretty much every week feel like months of progress, And the tremendous advances that we are doing and we announced in today AI Day, that's huge. And that will help all the developers, the open source community, all AI researchers to be able to get the latest advance in their hand at faster pace. We are releasing now our software at way faster pace. Any innovation we immediately productize and add it to the software. We get contribution from the open source community, which amplify and speed up our development. Something that you announced also in the AI Day is a log linear transformer was released in June 4th, that 5 days ago. It's already up and running on AMD hardware. So we are moving very, very fast, and that will help the community at large. Yeah,
I think they should have called it the Fast and Furious 7.
Exactly,
instead of ROCm 7. good. So you know, speed is one part of it. We got compute. We're building the software stack. Are there other
One of the mentioned thing is about agentic system and other system. We need to look at the system end to end, and for AI, an agentic system exercise everything in the hardware, from CPU, from memory, from GPU, and we have all those components optimized for that at AMD. So looking at the system holistically end to end, and how we can get the best performance, TCO, both on training and inference, that I believe is huge.
That's good to hear. And So for someone who does not know anything about agentic systems, what would be your, like, how do you explain it to someone who doesn't know AI, who doesn't know agents?
That's a great question. So agentic system is simply a running process or an agent that proactively doing multiple tasks. So you don't need to open a ChatGPT and write the prompt. It automatic do some task for you. This task might be optimizing code or write code for you, might be arrange your schedule, do some business planning or others. So agentic system is chain of process or agent that communicate with each other, use LLM as the back end, and tie that all together so it can automate, amplify, pretty much automate part of the stuff that require manual work and speed up and be able to scale your business and your work. Yeah.
So a real virtual assistant.
Exactly.
That can do. That's awesome. And you know, talk a little bit about like AI talent. You know, I came to AMD through an acquisition. AMD in the recent past has acquired Briam, Untether. There's like augmentation of skills, but also there's organic, inorganic methods. You know, just how do we get the best people to come in and join this journey?
The best people are, it's extremely important to have the best talent in AI that covers the entire stack, both from applied AI all the way to system programming and even hardware level. And this can get it into hiring, and we are hiring a lot. So if you are interested, please apply, but also inorganically by buying top talent and top company. For example, Node AI, we get huge expertise in compiler. Briam in compiler, also Lamini in Gen AI and in AI and others. So we are keep build silo, which have a huge presence both in AI solution and the end-to-end AI solution, and they build a lot of language model for European market. So those are extremely important to keep building and get higher top talent and attract them to AMD. And we are doing both organic and inorganic. Yeah.
If you're looking for a job, reach out to Emad or to me. AMD is hiring in all layers of the software stack, hardware stack. Well, thank you, Emad. Thank you for joining us.
Thank you, Anush.